Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon so you're notified when we have new videos. The next version of Android, simply called as Android P as of now, is slated to arrive sometime in Q3 this year. But for those who can't wait, you can sample it through the first developer preview that Google has just released. Now, this is still a very early build of Android P, specially aimed at app developers so that they can tinker around and get their apps ready for the real thing in the coming months. As far as Google's devices go, Android P will only officially support the first and second generation Pixel smartphones, which means it's the end of the road for major updates for the Nexus 5X and the 6P. Now, the developer preview 1 is not yet part of the Android beta program, which means in order to get it, you'll have to manually flash it on your phone. Just a word of caution before we proceed, flashing this ROM will wipe out all your existing data, so do make sure you have a full backup first. Also, we don't really recommend using this on your primary phone since there are bound to be bugs and glitches. You can find links to the factory images and instructions in the description below. We've used a Pixel 2 smartphone to test out Android P. Now before we begin, you'll need to ensure that OEM unlocking and the USB debugging toggle switches in developer options is enabled. Now it's time to check if the bootloader is unlocked. Hold down the volume button and then press power button till you get to the bootloader screen and check the last entry called device state. If it says it's locked, you'll need to download fastboot and using a command prompt or terminal window, navigate to the folder where it's downloaded and unlocking using this command. Once unlocked, you can now begin the update to Android P. Once you've downloaded all the factory images for your phone from Google's website, using a command line interface once again, you can go ahead and flash the bootloader, radio, and finally the main image file itself. It will take about a minute or two to unpack and install Android P onto your phone, so be patient. Now once done, your phone should automatically boot up to the setup screen. The first thing you'll notice here is a design change for the notification shade and the notifications themselves, which now have rounded edges. The ambient display will also now show you the battery percentage at the bottom in real time. In the notification shade, there's now a fourth row that's been added, so you can add more shortcuts. The volume button now lets you control the media volume by default instead of the ringer volume, and you can switch between different profiles from here itself. The settings app is also redesigned with more colorful icons which actually look pretty nice. You get a new shortcut for taking a screenshot when you hold down the power button, and finally, there's native support for adding annotations through a new markup tool. You can crop and write stuff on the screenshot before sending it or saving it. Android P also adds official support for notches, or as Google calls it, displays with cutouts. You can find this setting in the developer options and can switch between different sizes to simulate how your apps will look like on different phones. Obviously, this is just meant for developers at the moment. Google has also worked on improving notifications, especially for messaging apps. You'll be able to view the message thread and reply to messages directly from the notification bar. Smart replies from Google Allo are also coming to the notification bar, which is set to suggest contextual replies based on your chat history. Some of the other improvements include better security features, as Android P will prevent inactive apps from accessing the microphone and camera, a new autofill API, which will allow more third-party password manager apps to use this feature, and support for the new 802.11mc Wi-Fi protocol for taking advantage of indoor positioning in apps. We've only just scratched the surface here with Android P, as Google will no doubt be adding more features over the coming months, some of which we might get to hear about during Google I/O in May, which is the company's annual developer conference. So that is a quick first look at Google's brand new Android P, and for all things tech, log on to Gadgets360.com.